everybody. This is Dr. Leonard with Central Ohio Spine and Joint. In the last few weeks, we've talked about creating a directional preference with our patients that they come into the office dealing with either neck or back pain. And again, just to kind of recap what directional preference is that is purely based on the description our patients give us on either positions or movements that give them either more or less pain. And then based on that information, we create a treatment plan specific to those movements, whether it's flexion or extension. I wanted to talk about a concept today that we do deal with a decent amount, and that is when patients do not respond to either flexion or extension, these kind of directional preferences. When we have those patients come into the office, the vast majority of them experience symptoms as what they would describe as, you know, essentially tightness, stiffness, or even compression of the low back. When we look at those conditions, I wanted to show you this diagram here, which really kind of depicts it well. And that is when we see these conditions where there's a lot of tension in the back, usually what we're seeing is hyperactivity of the muscles of the lumbar spine. You can kind of see from this diagram, this is the back, this is the front. When you have that hyperactivity of these muscles, you actually create some of that compression within the lumbar spine. And on the model here, again, with this being the back, this being the front, when those muscles contract, what they're essentially doing is compressing the low back. You can get some compression of the discs, the nerves, and even of these little facet joints in the back here. So when we have patients that come in with this compressive or hyperactivity of the low back, a couple techniques that we utilize are traction type movements. And what I wanted to go over today was 4, 5, maybe even 6 movements that you can do on your own to try to help open up the low back and create a little bit of decompression or traction within the spine itself. So we're gonna go over a couple of these movements. Okay, so the first exercise we're gonna show here for these basic kind of self-traction moves, we talk a lot about creating that inner abdominal pressure or some expansion when you take in a big deep breath. So in this position, this is similar to like a child's pose position. What we're doing here is we're essentially opening up the low back. Like we talked about, when those muscles are hyperactive, they place a lot of compression back through here. So if you see in this position, what we're doing is we're actually rounding out the low back to turn off these paraspinal muscles. Then from this position, when we talk about kind of that deep expansive type breathing, when Jordan takes in a big deep breath here, when he breathes in and he expands, what you can feel is you can actually feel the back starting to open up a little bit with each deep breath. When you expand and you elongate these spinal erectors, you're almost creating some of that self-traction or decompression. So a very, very basic one to start with here. Like I said, you know, you can either start kind of up in all fours here like this, and then slowly work your way back into more flexion within the low back. Obviously, if you have anything like a disc herniation or acute back pain, sometimes this can be a little bit uncomfortable. So make sure to check with us first before jumping into this position. But this is probably the most basic one that we prescribe for our patients. Okay, the next one we're going to talk about for this self-traction move is basically just a hanging position. Hanging position is a great exercise, not only for, you know, the shoulders and upper back, but it does allow for a lot of traction and decompression of the lumbar spine. So in this position, what Jordan's doing is just kind of dead hanging. He's relaxing his lower body. We can even have him go into a little bit of posterior pelvic tilt, which flattens out the low back and again turns off the spinal erectors. Go ahead and relax. We typically recommend more of a cyclic type pattern where you're hanging for maybe about 10 seconds, taking a 10 second break, 10 seconds, 10 second break. You can do this either before exercise, after exercise. You can do this in essentially like a door jam at home. It doesn't have to be in the gym, but hanging is a great exercise in order to really decompress that low back. Okay, the next one we're gonna do here with Jordan is a basic traction move that you can do in the gym with a nice thick band like this. So what you do is you stand inside the band here. Jordan's gonna put it up on his waist, kind of up on the belt line here. And then he's gonna lay flat on his back, taking some tension into that band, so scooting it back just a little bit. From this position, what you can do is you can either rest your feet on the rack here, or you can just kind of relax your feet at 90 degrees. And what this is doing is this band is placing some nice traction on that low back. From here, what Jordan can do is he can take some nice deep abdominal breathing like we've talked about in order to really let that pelvis just kind of sink in and let this band traction out the low back itself. Another option is you can always place something like a kettlebell up overhead here that you can hold on to and place some traction on either end. Again, it comes down to the breathing though. When you take that big deep abdominal breath, you're actually creating some of that expansion. The band is just helping traction out the low back a little bit better. All right, the last one we're gonna talk about here on the self-traction movements is basically bending over a Swiss ball like you see right here. The bigger the Swiss ball, the better. So what Jordan is doing here is just kind of dead laying, letting his pelvis relax and kind of sink down into the ball here. Again, you can utilize some of that deep breathing in order to create a little bit more expansion within the spinal erector. So take in a big deep breath for me. Good, let it out. As you let it out, you kind of let that pelvis sink a little bit further and really try to open up that back. Again, like the last exercise, you could always have something out front here to hold on to provide a little bit of traction either way. But again, really focus on that deep abdominal breathing in order to open up the spinal erector muscles on the back.